The story is narrated by the character Dr. Watson, originally a physician. In 1887, he published A Study in Scarlet, the first of four novels about Holmes and Dr. Watson. In addition, Doyle wrote over 50 short stories featuring the famous detective. The Sherlock Holmes stories are generally considered the milestones in the field of fiction. His notable works include Stories of Sherlock Holmes and The Lost World. About the authors are Arthur Ignatius Conan Doyle. His birth is 1859 and died in 1930. Was a British writer best known for his detective fiction featuring the character of Sherlock Holmes, which are generally considered milestones in the field of crime fiction. Doyle wrote 46 short stories featuring the famous detective.
The detective Sherlock Holmes was seriously ill. He wanted to meet his assistant Watson. He asked his landlady to get him. Watson was surprised to see the condition of his master. Was Watson able to save his master? Read on to know more about the underlying story behind Holmes' sickness. There is little I can tell you, sir. He has been working on a case down at Rotherhithe, near river, and has brought this illness back with him. He took to bed on Wednesday afternoon and has never moved since. For 3 days neither food nor drink has passed his lips.
Why did you not call your doctor?
He would not have it, sir. I didn't dare to disobey him.
My dear fellow, stand back, stand right back. But why? I want to help you. Certainly, Watson, but it is for your own sake. For my sake? I know what is the matter with me. It is the disease from Sumatra. It is deadly and contagious, Watson, that is it by touch. Good heavens, Holmes, do you think this can stop me? If you will stand there, I will talk. If you don't, you must leave the room. Holmes, you're not yourself whether you like it or not. I will examine your symptoms and treat you.
To have a doctor, let me at least have someone in whom I have confidence.
Then you have none in me.
In your friendship, certainly. But facts are facts, Watson. You are a general practitioner, not a specialist of a disease.
Let me bring Sir Jasper Meek or Penrose Fisher or any other best man in London.
How ignorant you are, Watson. What do you know about tarpenil fever or the black farmer's plague?
I've never heard of them.
There are many problems of the disease in the East. I've learned that much during my recent researches, and during this course I caught this illness.
I will bring Dr. Ainstree then.
You won't have the key by force from me, Watson. Be here till 6 o'clock. It is 4 now.
This is madness, Holmes.
Only 2 hours, Watson. Then you can get a doctor of my choice. You can read some books over time. Down at once, Watson. I hate to have my things touched.
Okay, relax. I'm not going to touch your things.
Now, Watson, have you any change?
Yes.
How many half crowns? Put them in your watch pocket and all the rest in your trouser pocket. You will light the gas lamp, but it must be half on. You will have the kindness to place some letters and paper on the table within my reach. Now place the ivory box on the table. Slide the lid a bit with tongs. Put the tongs on the table. Good. Now you can go and fetch Mr. Culverton Smith of 13 Lower Bourke Street.
I've never heard of the name.
Well, he's the man who has the knowledge of the disease, but he is not a medical man. He is a planter. He He lives in Sumatra, now visiting London. I didn't want you to go before sex, because then you would not have found him in a study. You will be able to persuade him to come. You will tell him exactly how you have left me. Till that time, die. Plead with him, Watson.
I'll bring him in a cab.
You will persuade him to come and return before him. Now, make any excuse.
How is he?
He is very ill.
That's why I have come. Mr. Holmes has a high opinion of you and thought you are the only man in London who can help him.
Why?
Because of your knowledge of the Eastern dishes.
How did you get it?
Well done, Watson. You have done everything that your good friend could do. Now you disappear to the next room and don't speak or come here.
Holmes, Holmes, can you hear me? Is that you, Mr. Smith? You know what is wrong with me? You're the only one in London who can cure me. Do you know the symptoms?
Only too well, Mr. Smith. They are the same, Holmes. Poor Victor was a dead man on the fourth day. A strong and healthy young man. What a coincidence indeed.
I know that you did it.
Well, you can't prove it.
Give me water, please.
Here.
Cure me, please.
Well, about Victor Savage's death.
You did it. I will forget everything.
But cure me, I will forget about it.
You can forget or remember just as you like.
It doesn't matter to me how my nephew died, Watson said.
You got it from the Chinese sailors.
Could there be any other reason?
I can't think, my mind is gone.
Help me.
Did anything come by post?
A box by chance.
On Wednesday?
Yes, I opened it and there was sharp spring inside it.
A joke perhaps, it drew blood.
No, it was not a joke.
You fool, you have got it. Who asked you to cross my path?
You know too much about Victor's death. Your end is near, Holmes.
I will carry this box in my pocket, the last piece of evidence.
Turn up the gas, Smith.
Yes, I will.
So that I can see you better.
What's all this?
Successful acting. For 3 days I didn't taste anything.
Neither food nor drink. I arrest you on charge of murder.
And attempt of murder of Sherlock Holmes too.
Sorry, Watson, I was rude to you. I undermine your capability as a doctor.
It was just to get Smith here. And I didn't want you to know that. I was not ill.
At your appearance, 3 days fasting and the makeup did the trick.
I need to eat now, Watson. Mr. Smith killed his nephew. And he wanted to kill me, the same way to avoid imprisonment.
I need to eat now, Watson. And thank you, Watson.